Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 18.6 to the public. iOS 18.6 is available around the world at the same time for everyone, and if you're not seeing the update, you can find it by going to Settings, General, and then Software Update. You should see the update here. If you're not, you can just swipe back and then check it again, and you should see the update. However, if you're running the latest iOS 26 betas, whether you're a developer or public beta tester, you won't see the update as you're on a newer version, testing out the latest features that are coming later this year. If you wanted to install iOS 18.6, you would need a computer to downgrade to that version. Otherwise, if you're on iOS 18.5 or older, you should see this update. Now, along with this, Apple also released quite a few other updates: iPadOS 18.6, macOS 15.6, updates for tvOS, HomePodOS, visionOS, watchOS, and older iPads and Macs as well. Now, this update supports all iOS 18 supported devices, from the iPhone XS, XS Max, all the way up to the iPhone 16 Pro and 16 Pro Max. Now, this update does have some updates and changes. However, this is mostly a bug fix and security update. There is a modem update if you're updating from iOS 18.5 to this version. However, if you're on iOS 18.6 RC, you shouldn't see a modem update as you're already on that version. So no changes there, but if you're on the public versions, you'll see a modem update. This update does seem to allow for changes for the EU or European Union with regulations due to the overall App Store. So if we go to this post here from 9to5 Mac and scroll down, basically it brings it in compliance for allowing third-party app stores to be installed with less warnings and just sort of an updated change to the interface. So that's something that's specific to this update. However, if you're in the United States, for example, you won't see this change. Now, there's also going to be some enterprise updates, and that's for those that are managing a large amount of devices. However, Apple typically takes a day or more to update this web page, so we won't see that just yet. Also, there were hints of new AirTags in this update. Now, we'll probably see those later this year if Apple's going to release them, but it should help with things such as overall connectivity, range, maybe some additional features we weren't expecting. So that's something we could see a little bit of an update to, maybe better battery life, but again, should take some time before they're released. Originally, it was thought that this would be an update for China to have Apple Intelligence. So far, we're not seeing that, so it looks like maybe Apple hasn't included that with this version. But again, this does include some other changes. Before we talk about the bug fixes, there was some updates to splash screens. So the first time you go into specific apps, sometimes you'll see different splash screens. So it depends what app that is, but Journal, for example, you'll see it just popped up there again. So there's a new splash screen in Journal for me. I also saw one when I went into Reminders as well. You'll see again, it just popped up there. So there's a new one in Reminders. Also, if we go into the Fitness app, there was one here. So let's find that. Go into Fitness, you'll see a new splash screen there. And these are just going over features we probably were already aware of. And again, another one in Voice Memos, so record a vocal layer. So these are some changes that I'm seeing. Let me know if you're seeing these. I saw them only in those four apps, but it can vary depending on device. Now, as far as bug fixes, Apple did tell us about one. However, there are more than just one. But the one they specified has to do with a photo issue that could prevent memory movies from being shared. So if you're in Photos, in the Photos app itself, and you'll see I have a memory here with a movie attached, tap on it again, go to the three-dot menu, tap on Share, and it now works properly. So for some people, this wasn't working. It should be working properly now. There's quite a few other fixes as well that Apple doesn't list. For example, the Mail app is working properly again for many people on the iPhone and the iPad as well. It also seems to fix issues with Apple CarPlay, so many people were previously having issues on this. It should work properly now. It should also fix a lot of the notifications that seem to not be working properly or even showing up for some. And also it works for notifications throughout the OS. It fixes issues such as freezes and crashes, and also all of the stutters many people were having. This is super smooth overall. We'll talk about that a little bit more in a moment. And also Bluetooth and Wi-Fi connectivity seem to be resolved in this one. For example, my family was having a lot of issues with it just randomly disconnecting from Wi-Fi for no reason. I've seen that fixed on iOS 18.6 betas so far, and it looks like it's resolved for everyone finally. So there's been a lot of issues that Apple's addressed and fixed in this update, and probably some more, but they just don't list them, unfortunately. Now with iOS 18.6, Apple is including new security releases and updates. And you'll see on Apple's security release website, if we scroll down, we'll see the last version here, as Apple can take an hour or two, or sometimes a day or more, to update this website with the latest security patches. You'll see currently we have the last version, iOS 18.5 and iPadOS 18.5, and even sometimes weeks or months later, they update this with a new security patch as well. So this definitely will have important information here as to what they've patched, but we won't know that for a little while at this point. But I'll link it in the description so you can check it out as well. So if you're wondering if you should install iOS 18.6 due to the security patches and more, I would say absolutely. During the beta test, this was the most stable and secure update, so I would highly recommend it if you're not already on it. As far as other releases, well, Apple did release a new AppleCare update, and I'll share that here. So if we go to Apple's newsroom, you'll see AppleCare 1, and this is something I've updated to already so I could share the experience with you. But basically, it allows you to cover 3 devices for $19.99 per month against accidental damage, repairs, and other things as well. And then you can add additional devices for $5.99 per month. So if you're already covering 3 devices, whether that's an iPhone 16 Pro Max, maybe another phone or an iPad or a Mac, you can cover those all together and save about $11 per month doing it that way. It's only available in the US currently, and you can sign up on your iPhone or Mac. But if we go into our settings, under our settings, we'll go back to General, and then under General, AppleCare and Warranty, and you'll see AppleCare 1 devices, and I have 3 listed here. Now, many people were asking me, when you update to this, and maybe you've already paid for a year on maybe a MacBook for AppleCare, will they refund any money? And they will refund the money. So I updated to these 3 devices, the iPhone 16 Pro Max Black, Mac Studio, and MacBook M4 Max. And if we go over to Apple Wallet, you'll see in Apple Wallet that I had some refunds the other day when I signed up for this. So you'll see daily cash adjustments as well as refunds. This was for the monthly payment on the iPhone 16 Pro Max. And then we also have a couple that were refunded for the MacBook Pro as well as the Mac Studio. So that hopefully helps you out if you were thinking of signing up for AppleCare 1. It does seem they'll refund a prorated amount. Now, of course, Apple is working on iOS 26 and also soon to be working on iOS 27. That may support more devices, maybe folding devices in the future, but either way, they are working on those updates. As far as when the next releases will come out, well, of course, we could always see an iOS 18.6.1 or even an iOS 18.7 beta 1. If we do see a beta, we could see that sometime this week or next week. However, we're mostly focused on iOS 26 at this point. And iOS 26 beta 5 could be as soon as tomorrow, or it could be probably next week. So depending on what Apple decides to do, usually by beta 4 or 5, we're in weekly release schedule mode. However, with this week, it's been a little bit odd with the public beta releasing a little bit late this year. So we could see iOS 26 beta 5 probably next week with iOS 26 public beta 2 to go along with that. So maybe we'll see that this week. There's no guarantee of that, or we could see it sometime next week. But either way, we can expect that soon. And I think once the next beta is out, then we'll be on a weekly schedule if we're not already. Now, as far as overall performance, so far this has been really great. Most people using the earlier betas have said that it's the best update ever. It seems to be super smooth. Now, it could slow down over time, but things such as ProMotion are nice and fast, ramping up like you would expect, much better than before. If we go into things such as music, it loads nice and fast. Everything is just working like you would expect. So everything's quite good so far. And as far as the overall heat of the device, it's staying nice and cool, and I can show you that briefly. Now, the overall temperature in the hottest point you'll see with a thermal camera here is about 95 degrees Fahrenheit or about 35 degrees Celsius. Since I've had the phone in my hand, which is quite warm as well, it's actually well within range of what you would expect. It's not getting so hot that it would be a problem where you're concerned. Running iOS 26, I've seen that quite a bit where it just heats up randomly. iOS 18.6 seems to fix those issues. As far as overall battery life and battery health, well, first let's take a look at battery health. You'll see here on this device, this is not my main device. I'm at 100% capacity and 17 cycles. On my main device here, I'm at 96% and 277 cycles. So the iPhone 16 seemed to drop to about 99% after 250 cycles or so. As far as battery life, well, many people report it's quite good. Now, thanks to Abhishek for sending in his battery, you'll see this is on an iPhone 16e, so not the largest battery, but it's having great battery life. So you'll see 5 hours and 44 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 38 minutes of screen off time, and he's down to 17%. So pretty good for that particular device. In fact, that's really good for that device. And you can see the day before is similar at 5 hours and 46 minutes of screen on time for about the same amount of usage. So overall, pretty impressive with iOS 18.6. I've seen some people say 8 to 12 hours of screen on time, depending on device. So overall, very, very good. When it comes to benchmarks, it goes along with the overall performance, battery life, and this just being a more refined update. If we take a look at Geekbench 6, you'll see 3,577 for single core, 8,840 for multi-core. Some of the highest scores, if not the highest score I've ever seen for multi-core score with intensive processing. So overall, very impressive and definitely a reason to install this update if you haven't already. It seems like it's finally refined and one of the best ever. So that's everything with iOS 18.6, and it's definitely the best iOS 18 update ever, and it should be at this time of the year. We're towards the end of iOS 18, looking toward the next version of iOS 26, so it makes sense that it's quite refined. Hopefully they can get it right with iOS 26 right away, but at this point, this is a great update and definitely worth installing, as I mentioned before. Let me know your experience with it, though, in the comments below and what version you're using. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.